One extra explanation. Oh, my dad asked me if I can explain and say that he doesn't, he couldn't find another color. I don't know. This is what the man said. Today's mission was to go on the small island over there. We will show it later. Really small island surrounded just by sand, but with nice rocks. But on the way here, like in between the big island and the small island, there's a pinnacle, like a shallow area that is divided by deep sea, obviously, from all the sides. The water is clean. They say, the locals say, actually, he said that it should be fish here. Of course it will be. How much we still don't know. Ada ikan apa di sini? Sering mancing di sini? Orang mancing atau panah ikan juga?
Cuma sering mancing.
Sering.
Ada nauti, ada tenggiri, ada barakuda.
Tenggiri,
barakuda. Ada kurapu. Okay. Ada ikan merah.
Berapa dalam yang spot yang paling dangkal di sini?
Ini kedalamannya sekitar 20. 20, 15 sampai 20.
So the depth is from 15 to 20 meters. Like I was expecting, there are tenggiri, this is Spanish mackerel in Indonesian, trevalis, where there are rocks, there are always groupers and coral trout. They usually do just line fishing. The problem with their line fishing is that sometimes they can know all the nice spots for line fishing, but this can be really deep. This can be 70, 80 meters up to 150. So this is no help for us. That's why you always have to ask, what is the depth? What is the depth? They are usually exaggerating with the depth. So if they say it's 20 meters, it's not 20 meters. Here I can see we are on the shallowest spot. It's maybe 12 meters, something like this, but we will go a little, we'll try to go on the edge here and find some deeper spots that are even better usually. Mantap!
This island is very small, but there's still a lake on the island, and we're gonna check it now.
This is the lake. The diameter of this island is maybe 300 meters, but it has a lake. Very interesting to see. It doesn't look like an Indonesian nature, but nice.
is our pair of asses for this dinner. It's very difficult to see which one is tastier, so we have no choice but to eat them both.
And then, as usual, we realized we have too much fish, and we gave one fish to our cool neighbors. We just kept the coral trout.
Cooking of the tripang, sea cucumbers.
Ini yang paling mahal.
So those are the most expensive ones. I got those two, but they are not that expensive. I mean, they are good, but not like the other ones. So this is the tripang susu. Susu means milk. The milk sea cucumber.
Ini Gucci.
Ini Gucci.
Gucci.
Ah, this is Gucci. This is Gucci. The girls will know Gucci. Gucci.
Yes. Although we are in Papua, there are strict rules for collecting those sea cucumbers. On the island that we were today, it's allowed to collect them, so I took these two. But on the other parts, no. So they really respect these rules. It's really interesting to see, because in Europe we don't respect anything, pretty much most of the people, but here they do. It's nice to see. Itu apa, garam?
Yeah, garam.
Garam. Oh, they put some salt on it. Tapi ini harus kasih kering atau kasih garam langsung?
Kasih garam.
So those are like 500 per kilo. This is around $40, and this one is around $30 per kilo when they're dried. When they're dried, not like this, of course.
We have a mess here, but today was a tough day. Thank you.
home from the small island, and at one point I was considering putting my fins on just in case if we sink, because we were in a really small boat. The engines here, they work as long as they work, and if you get stuck with waves like this without the engine, we would be lost for sure. But we did it again.